in the dam rather than what are the energy generated. And so, how the effectiveness of this project? Answer is something different. Keep in mind, everything, the laws of physics are obeyed. Concept is that one can't depend only on this typical geographical situation for production of electricity. And so, another concept is developed that is called as thermal electricity. Now, I am just switching over topic. We are coming to point again, but it will take some time. And so, we are switching over to another topic. What is thermal electricity? In case of thermal project, the same thing is there, but instead of this situation, typical geographical situation, we are heating out schematically, we are heating out this water and the vapors are there released on generator. This is turbine. The vapors are released on turbine and because of that, turbine is rotating out, we are getting electrical current. So to rotate turbine, we are using energy that vapors are used. In order to vaporize water, we are using fuel and heat is produced. So this electricity is called as thermal electricity. Same, mechanism is same. But the thing is that in case of hydro power, this turbine is rotated because of water, whereas in case of thermal electricity, this turbine is rotated by water vapors. And that water vapors are obtained from heating out water by chemical method. Means we are using either naphtha or certain gases to burn, and then whatever heat is produced, that heat is used to vaporize water, and highly pressurized vapors are released on this turbine. Now in case of that, pollution is too much. Say whatever it is, naphtha, or if you are using any other fuel, ultimate combustion is combination with oxygen. That means it is consuming oxygen as well as carbon dioxide is released in air. And then we require something clean source. That clean source is called as nuclear power. Now in case of nuclear power plant, this is heated with nuclear reaction. For detail, you have to refer our nuclear chemistry lecture which is there. You can go by that. Because of that nuclear energy, the water starts vaporizing out, rest of the process is same. So in case of thermal electricity, same plan is there in case of nuclear power. The part is something technologically different. That instead of that we are using different coolant, molten sodium is used and all that. But basic thing is that water is vaporized by using nuclear heat, nuclear energy, and then that is used to rotate turbine. Now what is the problem? We are saying nuclear energy is clean source of energy. Yes, it is true, but certain problems are. In order to obtain uranium, lot of energy and lot of pollution is there. We are just purchasing out uranium, then already. But if uranium-235 is produced in our nation, then it is not that good. Anyway, there is destruction of environment is there, whether our nation or other nation. And that's why it is not safe to be clean, supposed to be. Say, where process is carried out, their process is clean. But in order to obtain enriched uranium, energy required is much. Now, there are development of breeder reactors. They are much more cleaner than whatever only uranium-235 or like that elements are used. Let us continue again. The second disadvantage of this nuclear power plant, that is, when we are starting out this power plant, we are not able to stop immediately. It will work throughout the day. Now what happened particularly in cities? Daytime energy requirement is very high, whereas nighttime energy requirement is low. But I can't stop this nuclear power plant once it is in function. So during daytime, the energy is used. During nighttime, energy is not used, but it is continuously produced in nuclear power plant. And therefore, what the connection is that this nuclear power plant is connected with this type of project, where that energy which is produced, I can't store that energy. So that energy is used to recycle water. Whatever water is coming down during daytime, that is stored temporarily and taken back to dam again during night time. And during daytime, when requirement of energy is high, this water is again used to produce electricity. So this is the basic thing that why this type of power plants are developed. Now hydroelectricity or hydel electricity, hydel power, this is no doubt efficiency wise not that high, but it is eco-friendly. It is non-polluting source of electricity, and as long as rain cycle, water cycle is there, it is inexhaustible source of electricity. And therefore, one should concentrate more on development of hydel power. But for that purpose, definite rainfall, then proper geographical conditions as mentioned here, like that conditions should require. Now, largest generation of hydroelectricity is carried out, that potential is there in Africa, potential. But because the development in this continent is not that much, the potential is not utilized to that level. Now, European countries like Switzerland, France, Italy, the Scandinavian countries, Japan and USA, they develop much of their potential for generation of this type of electricity. Now, European countries and Japan together account for 80% of total developed hydropower potential. Canada and Russia, they also develop their potential to great extent. In Asian countries, Japan, India and China are important in this field. This is about hydel power. In case of thermal power, USA is leading producer and consumer of thermal electricity, followed by Russia, Japan and then Germany. But in case of thermal power, it is not a clean process. It is not friendly with environment. You may say carbon dioxide is produced and carbon dioxide is required for plant. Yes, that is true. But carbon dioxide is also one of important greenhouse gas. And second, that whatever fuel is burnt away, heat is produced in the station, and that heat is ultimately entering in the atmosphere, and therefore heating effect is caused. Again, this is non-renewable source. Now in case of nuclear power, we discussed that once uranium-235 is there with you, the process is clean. We say practically no, because whatever uranium is produced, that consumed, that is giving rise after nuclear fission, several radioisotopes are developed. They are having half-life period of several lakh years. Thus, they will be long-lasting for several lakh years. And for that purpose, we are producing nuclear waste for new and upcoming generations. Right now, my requirement of energy is satisfied. We can't recycle this radioisotope, and no other uses of these radioisotopes are there. Simply we have to dump that in the desert. Usually process is that whatever the nuclear waste is there produced, that we are packing in thick lead boxes. In desert, we are making hole where cement chamber is constructed, then these lead boxes are buried out, then cement chamber is closed and everything is alright. Cement chamber will persist for thousands of years, lead boxes will persist for thousands of years, but inside material radioactive that will remain for lakhs years. And that is the biggest problem in nuclear energy. So this is also not that clean process. Now, for that we have to develop non-conventional sources of electricity. Actually, use of wind energy, I may say conventional as well as non-conventional, because the windmill was used in ancient world, but that was not used for generation of electricity. So we can say this is conventional as well as non-conventional. So what happened exactly? The windmill is set up. Say here we have suppose windmill. This will move like this. The rod is connected with here with gear system, and this will move this generator. Resulting, you should not consider every time this turbine is of night. Depending upon situation, weight of turbine changes. The energy produced this way, we are calling as energy produced from wind. Wherever this is also clean source of energy, and this is also non-polluting as well as we are saying with say comparatively high efficiency is obtained, but definite situations are required over here. In India, large windmill projects are developed because our requirement of energy is much more and we have resources. Now, apart from that, tidal energy, high tide and low tide, that energy is also used. The solar energy concept is only different from this windmill project or say this turbine project, because usually in case of solar energy, turbines are not used. Solar cells are used. They are made up of silicon wafer, and certain elements having very low IP value, cesium-like elements are used. Solar cells are supposed to be very good source, but what is the problem? It's very costly, and that's why it is not utilized in the world to that extent as it should be there. Apart from wind energy, geothermal energy and biomass energy is also used. Now, USA, Russia, France, United Kingdom, Germany, Sweden, Canada, these countries are mainly depending upon nuclear energy as their source. Apart from that, India is also in the race, but not competing directly. Now, geothermal energy is widely used in Iceland, whereas USA is also used this same source of energy. Tidal energy is utilized in France and number of other countries including India. The wind energy is not of much use, or it is not used to that extent, but Scandinavian countries, that is European, Northern European countries, they are much advanced in use of this wind energy. In India also, various windmill projects are developing, and this is clean source of energy as we have discussed. Biomass energy we should think of, because in India, tremendous biomass is there. Cattle, we can use for that biomass energy generation. So, alternatively, there is a fine day when all petroleum products will come to end or become more and more rare, and then we have to depend mainly on the non-conventional source of energy.